My name is Aviâja Lynge. I'm from Greenland and I am part of the indigenous people in Greenland and the Circum Polar North, the Inuit. For the last 14 years, I've been working on the issue of colonial influence on identity and self-esteem, particularly with regards to how the educational system, the colonial education system, have had an effect on people. And for the last 8 years, I've been working within the Greenlandic school reform, which is also a decolonizational process. And my advocacy issue within human rights is the with regards to education, rights to education and indigenous people. And I will try to give you an example of that. Imagine you are 15 years old and you just finished the elementary school. You speak your native mother tongue and you cannot really speak the colonial language, which is a requirement at the Western educational system if you want to go any further, take a high school or if you want university or any other education. Imagine you do know you cannot enter any education. And you might maybe, which is what happens many, many times, that you might maybe even have a sister who's sexually abused. You have parents who have problems with alcohol because that's the only way of finding peace inside. And imagine your future without an education where you know that it's very hard to get even a high, well-paid job. So imagine to be 15 years old and you can hardly see that you do have any future in a country or in an area where one of the greatest problems is already suicide. So the reality in Greenland is that when young people finish the education system at the elementary level, 62% of them cannot enter any further education because they have a different language and a different culture and a different way of learning. And for those who do actually access the higher educational system, up to 50% of them will also drop out again. So the problem here in terms of human rights, in terms of indigenous people's rights, and also for the policies with regards to education at different countries at the national and local levels is that we still have colonial educational systems which doesn't take into account the different ways of learning, different ways of speaking and approaching education. So there is still a continuous huge mismatch between the culture of the young people and the educational systems. So when we talk about access to education, which is the one being the word or the notion being used a lot within human rights and indigenous people's rights, I would say that it's not enough to work with access to education if you do not put the indigenous culture's context into that. Otherwise, we will see no changes for the future to come. So at the national level, we also need policies on institutions, educational institutions, who begin to take into account the different cultures of these young people. And at the local level, we really need to empower these young people because a lot of them, they don't even know that they have actually a right for education.